April 25th, 2025, India quietly made history. At a test facility in Hyderabad, Indian scientists ran a scramjet engine continuously for over 1,000 seconds, more than 16 minutes. No other nation has done that. Not the US, not China, not Russia. No dramatic headlines, no roaring jets, just a chamber in Hyderabad, and a revolution in the making. For the first time in world history, a scramjet engine, powered, designed, and tested by Indian scientists, ran continuously for 1,000 seconds. That's over 16 minutes of controlled fire at hypersonic speed. This wasn't just a test. This was a leap into the future, a moment that places India firmly among the elite few racing to dominate hypersonic technologies. The world noticed, quietly, nervously, because scramjets are the future of missiles, space travel, and warfare. And India just leapt years ahead, without fanfare, without foreign help. But to grasp how big this is, we must first understand the world of missiles, what they are, how they work, and why India's leap could rewrite the rules of modern combat. So let's dive deep into the types of missiles, the engines that power them, and how India's breakthrough could change the balance of power forever. Missiles are not just weapons. They are flying decisions, made in the blink of an eye, precise, relentless, and often unseen until it's far too late. They don't just travel, they hunt across valleys, deserts, oceans, even continents. Some glide low, skimming under enemy radars. Some rise into the heavens before slamming down like divine thunder. These are not just machines. They are the sharpest symbols of a nation's strength. Missiles are built for many missions, and each one is classified by how far it flies, how it flies, and where it launches from. Let's break it down the Indian way. By range, short range, think Prithvi. Quick, tactical strikes for nearby threats. Medium range, like Agni 2, deep penetration into enemy territory. Intermediate range, Agni 4, reaching farther, hitting harder. Intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs. Agni 5, built to cross oceans and send a message across the world. Don't test Bharat. By trajectory, ballistic missiles, launched high into space, then they drop. Fast, furious, unstoppable. Like a hammer from the sky, Agni series. Cruise missiles, fly low, twist through mountains and terrain, hugging the earth. Hard to detect, harder to stop. India's pride, the Brahmos, the fastest in the world. By launch platform, land, sea, air, even under the water. Today, Indian missiles can be launched from anywhere, anytime. But above all, one factor rules them all. Speed. Because in missile warfare, speed kills. Faster means deadlier. Let's talk speed. Not car speed, not jet speed. We're talking missile speed. Speed that doesn't knock, it strikes. We measure it in Mach, where Mach 1 is the speed of sound. Now listen closely. Subsonic missiles, like the American Tomahawk, crawl below Mach 1. They're slow, predictable, easy to intercept. Supersonic missiles, like our Brahmos, rip through the sky at Mach 3. That's 3,700 kilometers per hour, enough to shatter enemy timelines and confidence. But hypersonic missiles, they leave everything else behind. Mach 5 and beyond, that's 6,000 plus kilometers an hour. Some fly at Mach 20, almost 25,000 kilometers an hour, faster than a bullet. Faster than thought, faster than the enemy can even blink. By the time radar sees it, it's already home. By the time someone presses a button, it's too late. Who's building them? Russia has the Kinzhal. China flaunts the DFZF. America is racing with the ISRO. And India? We're not racing. We're arriving with a scramjet engine built not in Moscow, not in Washington, but in Hyderabad. India has proven we can power the missiles of tomorrow. No borrowed tech. No hand-holding, just Indian minds, Indian fire, Indian pride. Missiles don't fly on hope. They fly on fire. They fly on engines. Not ordinary engines, but machines that defy gravity, logic, and fear. Let's meet the titans of thrust, turbojet. the old guard, like aircraft engines with fans and turbines, good for basic speed, works for subsonic or low supersonic missiles. Effective, yes, but not game-changing. Ramjet, now we're talking power. No moving parts. It compresses air simply by flying fast. Fuels ignite. The missile screams forward. This powers the Brahmos, the pride of India, cruising at Mach 3. But then comes the king, the crown jewel, the beast built for the future, the Scramjet. A Scramjet, short for supersonic combustion ramjet, burns fuel while the air is still moving supersonically through it. Let that sink in. It's like trying to light a match in a hurricane at 6,000 kilometers per hour. No fans, no turbines, just pure physics, pure power, pure genius. But here's the catch. A Scramjet only works above Mach 5. That means it needs a booster missile to push it into hypersonic territory. And then it roars to life. Most countries are still trying to make it work for a few seconds. But India? We made it burn for 1,000 seconds straight. That's over 16 minutes of sustained hypersonic combustion. All done on Indian soil, by Indian scientists, for India's future. No help, no handouts, no fear. This is not borrowed brilliance, it's Bharat's breakthrough. This isn't just an engine, it's a declaration. India has entered the hypersonic age, and we didn't knock. We broke the sound barrier and the door. In the world of missiles, two beasts dominate the battlefield. One strikes from the stars, the other, like a phantom, dances through the skies. Let's compare the Titans. Ballistic missiles, like our very own Agni 5. Launched high into space, they soar, then drop like divine wrath, at speeds of Mach 20 or more. Unstoppable? Almost, but there's a catch. They follow a predictable path. You can see them coming, if your radar is fast enough, but outrunning them, still nearly impossible. Hypersonic glide vehicles, like China's DFZF. These don't go into space, they stay inside the atmosphere, flying low and fast. And they maneuver mid-flight. They zig, they zag, they vanish from radar, and they strike when you least expect it. Even the best missile shields can't catch what they can't lock onto. A ballistic missile, like India's mighty Agni V, launches into space in a giant arc, like a slingshot to the stars. It falls back to Earth at incredible speed, Mach 20 and beyond. But it follows a fixed path. Once it's launched, you know where it's headed. It's like watching lightning fall in slow motion, terrifying, but traceable. Now picture the other side. A hypersonic glide vehicle doesn't rise, it slides. It stays within the atmosphere, flying at Mach 5 to 10, still blisteringly fast. But here's the kicker. It moves unpredictably, twisting and turning mid-flight. You try to aim, and it's already somewhere else. Ballistic missiles are powerful sledgehammers. Hypersonic gliders are guided ghosts. One is fast and furious. The other is fast, furious, and almost invisible. And India? We're building both. We already have the firepower to strike from the stars. And now, with the Scramjet engine in our hands, we're gearing up to build missiles that breathe air, fly low, and dodge death itself. From Skyhammer to Sky Shadow, India is forging both weapons of war. We are not choosing one future, we're engineering them all.
India doesn't dream about missile power. We've already built it, and it's nothing short of formidable. Let's walk through the weapons that keep every enemy awake at night. Agni 5, our near ICBM. Range, over 5,000 kilometers. Speed, a mind-blowing Mach 24. That's 25,000 kilometers an hour, faster than anything most nations can even detect. Brahmos, the pride of India. The fastest cruise missile in active service anywhere in the world. Launched from land, sea, or air, and it never misses. ISRO, our very own air-to-air missile, precision engineered to strike enemy fighters before they know they're being hunted. And that's not all. We've got Shaurya for strategic stealth, Akash for air defense, and Nirbhay for long-range subsonic strikes. Land, air, sea, every domain is covered. Every threat has an answer. But now we step into a new era. The era of hypersonic flight. India's HSTD program, the Hypersonic Technology Demonstrator Vehicle, has already flown at Mach 6. That's over 7,000 kilometers an hour, burning through the sky. And what powers it? The Scramjet engine that ran for 1,000 seconds, the same engine that will soon drive the next giant, BrahMos 2, faster, smarter, unstoppable. From Agni to Astra, from BrahMos to beyond, India's arsenal isn't just ready, it's roaring. Why does this test matter? Because no one else has done it like this, not even close. Let's talk facts. The United States, the most advanced military power on Earth, managed a scramjet burn for just 240 seconds. Russia, they've made bold claims, but still no independent verification. China, shrouded in shadows, no data, no clarity, just whispers. But India, we did it in the open, in a ground test, with indigenous design, Indian software, and Indian brains. This wasn't just a test. It was a message to the world, loud and clear, that India's engineers can match the best, that India's infrastructure can support the future, and that India's intention is simple: peace through strength, progress through power. This 1,000-second burn is not just a number, it's not a spark, it's a torch, one that lights the path for hypersonic cruise missiles, space launch vehicles, and one day, reusable spacecraft that could lift off, orbit, and return, all made in India. This isn't just about fire, it's about future. And India just ignited it.
Missiles are not just machines. They are the heartbeat of a nation's resolve. Coded in metal, fueled by vision, and launched with unshakable will. And India's 1,000-second scramjet triumph, it didn't just prove we can keep up with the world, it proved we can lead it. This is more than a defense milestone. It's a scientific roar, a moment of engineering brilliance, and a declaration of strategic destiny. To every Indian watching, this isn't just DRDO's victory, it's your victory. Our minds, our hands, our soil, our sky. Let the world take note. We are not the followers in this race. We are the flame that lights the path ahead. India has arrived. And the sky? The sky is not our limit. It's just the beginning. Jai Hind.